What is up, Grade 9? Welcome to Sir Sabido's class. But before we begin, I would like you to be reminded of the following things. Number one, always jot down notes. Always keep your notebook with you and only write the things that are considered important within the discussion. Number two, you can pause whenever you want to. Number three, do not only watch the lesson and play the video, but instead, learn from it. On the previous discussion that we've had, we've talked about Philippine folk dance. So for today, we will be running down other examples of dances, as well as we will be recalling the definition of dance. So last discussion, hindi natin na-define exactly what dance is. And since second and third quarter is almost integrated to one another, they are actually connected to one another since both of the topics falls in the category of dance. Again, let us define what dance is. Ang dance, it is a form of art. Like music, like any other form of art, this is actually, syempre, accompanied by something. Sometimes, it is a way of a person or a certain individual in telling stories, in exploring different emotions, and of course, in expressing his or her own self. And in dancing, what's unique and different about it is it involves different movement through rhythm, and syempre, ginagamitan siya ng music. And here in grade 9, second and third quarter, dance is emphasized in various ways. Sobrang daming example na ibinigay last meeting, if you can remember, on the Philippine folk dance topic. So, madami tayong binigay na example ng dance doon. And today, we will be talking about one example of dance as well, which proves that dance is very unique and it can be done in various ways. So, hindi siya tulad ng ibang bagay that can be done in just one way. So, dancing can be done in multiple manners as well. So, ano yung pinag-uusapan natin one example? So, we have the ballroom dancing. For today, we will be talking about ballroom dancing. Ano nga ba yung ballroom dancing? What are different examples of ballroom dancing? And ano yung mga nakapaloob dito sa ballroom dancing itself? Starting with, of course, the definition of ballroom dance, what do we mean by ballroom dance? Ballroom dance is actually a genre or a type of a dance na discuss naman natin to last time or nabanggit naman that ballroom dance originally is a partner dance. So, partner dance, which means it requires two people dancing together. So, ballroom dancing is a social dance. So, when you say social dance, it's a dance which involves interaction from one person to another. And dati, it's used for solely, ang purpose niya lang parang for the purpose na makapag-mingle with other people. But eventually, it was enjoyed competitively kasi nga, it's a form of entertainment. So, ang main purpose ng ballroom dancing is for you to get to know other people since it's a part of a social function. So, ang ballroom dancing, one of the event that it is commonly used at is yung mga GS prom, what else, yun nga sa sports fest, dance sport, ballroom dance ang ginagamit doon. Dati sa mga probinsya, sa mga sayawang bayan, they commonly use ballroom dancing. So again, that is the main reason kung bakit under siya ng social dances because of its fulfilling the social function itself. So there are different essential components in dancing, namely movement, music, and formation and position. Let's define each. Movement, from the picture, from the GIF, sabi nga dyan, it is, syempre, yung parts of your body, if it's moving from one place to another, it's movement. Music is the organized pattern of sound, while formation and position is essential in dancing. Bakit sila naging essential? Individually, yes, they are important, but together, mas importante sila when they are working together. Simply, you cannot dance without movement. So, hindi naman din pwedeng sasayaw ka nang wala kang tugtog. Music. And of course, it will be blunt and it will be very plain kung walang formation and position. Formation and position allows dancers to shift moods and also to shift the, para makita mong may pacing yung sayaw. You start, for example, you start with an open facing position, tapos mayami, lilipat kayo sa closing position. So, formation and position is, it serves as a transition from one part to another. And again, those three work hand in hand together in order for us to create a beautiful dance. Ngayon, ano naman yung importance ng music sa dancing? So, musical compositions is one of the reason kung bakit nagkakaroon ng flavor ang isang sayaw. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, a dance depends multiple times or most of the time sa tugtog. Minsan, kapag ang isang sayaw uses wrong music or inappropriate music, pangit panoorin, nakakatawad panoorin. Yung music na to, it can change from different moods. And this makes dancing, sabi nga dyan, more interesting. So, minsan nakaka-evoke ng mood ang dancing itself or the music that is used in dancing itself. And dapat, yung movements na ginagamit ng ating dancers, dapat syempre, in sync siya or in harmony in terms of the music. Kasi, kung ikaw sumasayaw ka, tapos wala ka naman sa timing, di ba ang pangit nung tignan? Parang the presentation of the dance itself will be very boring, will be very plain. And hindi siya magandang panoorin kung wala sa timing, syempre, yung mga sumasayaw doon or yung mga dancer mismo. Ngayon, formation naman. So, kung mapapansin nyo, ini-emphasize natin yung tatlo kung ano yung importance nila with dancing itself individually. Formation are transitions as well. Ito yung ginagamit or tinatawag nating change of formations and positions. This adds the beauty, of course, to the dance, help dancers to convey different messages so that alam ng mga nanonood na, nag-shift na pala sila ng scenario. There are dances which showcases stories. Alam naman natin lahat yun. So, yung formations and position, ginagamit siya para malaman ng mga nanonood na, nag-next scene na pala or it's a different part of the story already because of the transition itself. Definitely, sabi nga dyan, if there is no change in position and formation, it will be very boring. So, why should you be involved in dancing? So, bakit ka ba dapat magsayaw? Dancing keeps both the body and the brain active and mas, sabi nga nila, yung mga dancers, yung mind or yung brain ng mga dancers mas active as compared with those people who are doing other activities, physical activities. Because number one is for all ages. Pwede siya sa lahat ng edad. And, syempre, mahirap magsaulo ng steps. Ang tendency, yung utak mo mas naging active siya kasi you're thinking, you're formulating different steps as well. So, sobrang active ng brain mo kapag sumasayaw or gumagawa ka ng isang sayaw. It also helps you to learn about your body. It improves your posture, your balance, most especially ballroom dancing. Kasi ang ballroom dancing, one of the main requirements kapag sumasayaw ka nito, dapat yung posture mo, yung position mo, ay maayos, tama. Kasi kung hindi, it will not parang jive with the dance itself because that's a requirement. Dancing also offers different insights of other cultures. So sabi nga nung mga estudyante namin before, ako yung mga na-handle ko sa PE, "Sir, why do you keep insisting on dancing, making us dance ng mga gantong sayaw? Sir, bakit niyo po kami pinapasayaw ng folk dance? Bakit po ba kailangan namin magsayaw ng mga social dances?" This is the main reason why. Because dancing offers insights to other cultures. Lahat yon, kung mapapansin nyo, hindi naman natin nakagisnan. In short, in our generation, pinanganak tayo dito sa mundo na hindi naman yun yung nakagawian natin gawin. So, these projects, these activities, makes you or makes us look back to the culture that we've had or the culture that the other countries, the other cultures, parang binibigyan tayo ng idea, ah, ganito pala yung pakaramdam ng sumasayaw ng ganito. And also, through dance itself, we also meet people. Diba? We meet people, even if by just watching videos from YouTube, you're watching examples from different sites like Facebook and other video sites. Parang, diba, indirectly, nai-introduce ka to other people na parang, ah, ganun pala yung ginagawa ng gantong culture. That's importance. Bakit sumasayaw kayo? Bakit nyo ito ginagawa? Bakit lagi na lang sa PE, sa MAPE, kailangan mag-folk dance sa kakasawa? That's the main reason. It offers insights. Plus, binubuhay nyo yung essence ng mga traditional dances and social dances as well. So, also, it leads you to new career opportunities. Alam naman natin that there are people na nahahanap nila yung passion nila in dancing. Malay nyo naman, di ba, hindi tayo magaling academically. Baka naman dito ka mag-excel. Di ba? Also, ginagamit siya for improvement ng communication skills that is actually used for different professions. Not just in dancing professions, but also in other professions as well. It offers a creative outlet. It makes people creative. And yung mga tao minsan na gumagawa ng mga sayaw, kung napapansin nyo ha, kapag may isang tao sa classroom nyo na nagpa-facilitate ng mga performances, di ba parang nagugulat ka na lang na, ah, yun pala yung kaya niyang ibigay na suggestion. Parang even you. Ah, ganun pala, pwede palang ganun. Parang those thoughts that you cannot use for other purposes, dancing sometimes becomes an outlet. Ito yung nagsiserve as yung mga thoughts mo na, alam mo, yung mga playful thoughts in terms of expression, dito mo pala mailalabas in dancing. What are the different benefits of dancing in coordination with why should you dance? Number one benefit, it improves your heart and your lungs since it's a cardiovascular exercise or activity. And ang difference niya with other activity, yung other activities kasi, it makes you feel tired, it makes you feel exhausted. Ang dancing, di ba pag halimbawa nag-zumba ka, zumba-zumba ka, parang little did you know, you are actually exercising without you knowing it because you are enjoying it. Masaya siya gawin eh. Next, it increases your muscular strength, your endurance, and your motor fitness. Sir, pati po muscle na i-improve sa dancing, yes. Kasi when you are dancing, you are mostly using all parts of your body. So parang yung strength ng muscles mo, it is being parang enhanced. Endurance mo, you can last longer without feeling like you are catching your own breath. Motor fitness, kasi we use different motor skills when we are dancing. You are moving from one place to another. Kaya nai-improve din siya. It then also improves your muscle tone and your strength. Of course, it can aid in weight management. Again, you are losing without you knowing because you are enjoying. That's dancing. What else? It can also promote stronger bones and can reduce the risk of osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is sakit po yan sa buto. Mostly occurs at ages ng or older ages. Better coordination, agility, and flexibility. Coordination is being able to move parts of your body simultaneously. Ang agility, ability to change direction. Pag flexibility, you are able to extend your muscles. Parang you are able to use your muscles more or you can extend it more. And can stretch it. Flexibility is mostly used in stretches or stretching. Na may mga steps that requires coordination, agility, and flexibility as well. It improve balance and spatial awareness. And improve general and psychological well-being. Ngayon, kapag parang feeling mo ang dami mong iniisip, diba, that's the main reason kung bakit parang yung mga tao, mostly, ngayon, nahihilig sa TikTok. Simply because of this. Kasi nga, it improves psychological well-being. As a review of your skill-related fitness component that are essential in dancing, so ito yung mga natatarget niya. Number one, we have balance. Balance in definition is the ability to maintain an upright position while you are standing, also by moving. Balance is also the equilibrium of one's body. But there are people na it's hard for them to keep their own balance. Parang may instances na hindi kayang mag-stay in an upright position, so that's balance. Number 2, coordination. Nabanggit ko naman kanina yung coordination. Linking of senses. And you are being able to produce a smooth, a quick, and efficient controlled movement, lalo na sa dancing. Strength, muscles ability to generate force against physical objects. So these are the skill-related fitness component that are considered as essential in dancing itself. Now let us talk about different types of ballroom dances through this video.
What are the 5 ballroom dances? There are 2 styles of ballroom dancing, American and international. American style is danced mostly in the USA. Essentially, the standard and smooth categories have the very same dances, and the Latin and rhythm classifications consist of generally the same dances. In competitions, this is how they listed by dance. American style. American smooth dances consist of waltz, tango, foxtrot, and Viennese waltz. Rhythm dances consist of cha-cha, rumba, East Coast swing, West Coast swing, bolero, mambo, and samba. International style. International standard dances consist of waltz, tango, Viennese waltz, foxtrot, and quickstep. While Latin consist of cha-cha, samba, rumba, paso doble, and jive. The 5 most popular ballroom dances worldwide are rumba, foxtrot, waltz, cha-cha, and swing. Dancers proficient in these 5 dances can dance with partners from any area of the world. Here's a simple explanation of the leading most popular styles of ballroom. Waltz. When someone discusses ballroom dancing, this is the most typically thought of dance. It is 28 bars per minute, performed in 3/4 time, and it can be reasonably romantic. Foxtrot. Foxtrot is an all-American dance set to jazz music and can be slow or fast, depending upon the band. Cha-cha. This dance is a fun and sexy dance with a highlight on quick, compact foot and leg actions. Rumba. This dance has a sexy feeling with lots of hip and body action, referred to as Cuban motion. Swing. The most typical swing dance in competitions is the East Coast Swing, a design established by Arthur Murray and others right after the Second World War. People all over the world enjoy the competitive and social nature of ballroom dancing. Ballroom dancing, quick overview. Ballroom dancing was established in England. Ballroom dance was noticed in the 16th century in France for the very first time. Throughout the very first half of the 19th century, a lot of ballroom dances, such as the polka and the waltz, were an essential part of gatherings called assemblies, planned nights or community, such as a regiment or a hunting group. Socially appreciated figures, such as the patriarch of a landowning family group, the master of the hunt, or the colonel of the local regiment, were the usual sponsors of these events, and stringent guidelines of etiquette were followed throughout the evening. In the early 20th century, ballroom dance became very popular in the United States with the hugely successful style of dancing from Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. Even though the majority of their numbers were diligently choreographed, staged, and oft rehearsed, they affected ballroom dancing's acclaim and acceptance greatly. The World Dance Council is in charge of organizing the dance competitions. The World Dance Council Limited, WDC, previously understood as the International Council of Ballroom Dancing, ICBD, up until 1996, was developed at a conference arranged by PJS Richardson on September 22, 1950. Consisting of 9 European nations and 3 others, today, the WDC has become the leading authority on competitive ballroom and Latin dance. It has members in lots of countries throughout the world. Ballroom dance evolution, quick introduction. In Europe, partnered dancing is done in a wide range of styles, both casual and pro forma. However, the most visible and promoted form is what the English call international style ballroom, which is based on dance sport, technique and styling. Early competition appearance. Modest clubs in London began to hold events of a single dance kind, like foxtrot or tango, in the early 1920s. Then the very first English ballroom dance competition in combined types premiered in March 1922. A more friendly approach. Ballroom competitors began to introduce more comprehensive and more exaggerated motions into their dancing throughout the 1930s. These changes happened in three phases, for three different factors. The first stage didn't originate from the associations or the judges' preferences. It came from the audience's response. One of the very first examples was with the competition ballroom tango. To quote Richardson once again, because he was among the judges at that time, rivals discovered that these overstated movements, especially a sudden turn of the head when altering instructions in the tango, made the kudos of the viewers, if not the marks of the judges. The quickstep was likewise going through a stage of eccentricity. These changes happened because of the desire of rivals to win approval from the crowd. These movements were sometimes condemned by the judges initially, however, the associations didn't like the new changes, but they eventually gave in, and it became the brand new characteristic.
The last part is safety in dancing. So ayan, ano ba yung mga dapat kayong maging aware in terms of dancing or kapag sumasayaw kayo? And I just want you to know and remember that accidents happen most of the time, even in dancing. So marami ding mga possible na mangyari kapag sumasayaw tayo. So you have to learn what are the safety in dancing. So there are injuries or activities or events that happens when you dance. So cramps and sprains yung mostly na nangyayari or possible injuries that you can catch, hindi naman literally lahat or lahat ng oras all the time magkakaroon ganito, but there are some people na ito yung usual injuries or accidents na they are experiencing when dancing, and you should know paano nga ba i-treat and how to apply first aid to avoid further injury. Kasi syempre kapag naman sumasayaw kayo, mostly either your somewhere with pwedeng your friends or with your classmates or coach. So hindi naman all the time kailangan i-approach mo yung coach mo. So you can do first aid by yourself. Paano po yun gawin? So here on the slides, following slides, let's have a review of the definition of sprain. Kasi na-discuss ko naman ito sa health. But let us review. Sprain is an injury which is a result from an accident wherein violently you were able to wrench or twist your ligaments either sa ankle, wrist, or sa joint, which can cause, of course, pain and swelling. So sabi nga sa inyo, yung sprain, common yan sa mga joints natin or yung mga connecting na part of our body. Lalo na sa may ankle, that's the most common na nangyayari ang sprain. So even in dancing, it can happen. Lalo na sa dancing kasi alam naman natin na may mga movements ng paa. Mostly, yan ang ginagamit. So ito yung natatarget most of the time ng injuries. What is the first aid of sprain? So protection. Put a support on the injury so that there are no more damages. After you protect the area, either pag protection kasi, pwede mo lagyan ng pwedeng lagyan mo ng kalang or pwedeng lagyan mo ng cover. You can protect the part so that wala nang further damage. Rest is very important. Nakalagay dyan, no, 48 to 72 hours na wala kang activities. Sabihin, technically speaking, kapag severe ang pinag-uusapan natin, 48 to 72 hours. Kasi hindi ka rin naman makakalakad ng maayos eh. Pero kapag mild lang, by resting for a couple of hours or minutes even, you can move. You can use it again. So, protection, rest. Next, we have ice. So, you can apply ice 15 to 20 minutes within 72 hours. And after the injury, or it is used to lessen the injury itself. So, yung swelling, it reduces further damage. So, every 3 hours, but do not leave the ice touching the skin as it can cause ice burn. Compression, use different bandages or elastic bandages to reduce movement and swelling para hindi na din furtherly ma-affect yung area. You elevate because sabi nga natin, di ba, kapag higher ang injury sa heart, mas mabilis siyang gagaling, or to hasten the recovery, pwedeng gumamit ng pillow or other materials to support the injured part. And so that's, again, let's have a recap. Protection first, rest, you apply ice, compression, and elevation. Commonly called as PRICE. PRICE. Yun yung acronym na ginagamit natin for spring. Ayan. Protection, rest, ice, compression, and elevation. So that is PRICE. Next, number two, and the last one is cramps. Cramps or muscle cramps occur when the muscle contracts and hindi nagre-relax. Yung muscles natin becomes hard, tight, and painful. This can be a result of the following. Pwedeng dehydration, kulang ka sa tubig, kulang ka sa liquid sa katawan mo. Number two, pwedeng fatigue muscles or overusing of muscles. And also, it can be because of lack of electrolytes. Electrolytes like potassium and magnesium. Yung electrolytes, ito yung nakikita natin sa mga energy drink like Gatorade, Powerade, Pocari Sweat. Dun sila common. Kaya di ba kapag mga athletes, bakit ba sir, yun, if you were asking, sir, bakit ba Gatorade? Bakit po Powerade? Bakit po hindi na lang putang na orange or other drinks? It's because it contains electrolytes. So, this prevents lack of electrolytes sa katawan natin para ma-avoid yung cramps. What can you do to prevent muscle cramps? Since kapag nangyari na kasi siya, hindi na siya kayang, as in, you just need to wait for it to parang mag-subside. Kasi di ba sobrang sakit ng muscle cramps? Yung parang pag alam mo, nagsiswimming ka, tapos bigla ka na lang nag-muscle cramps. Ayun. That's how it feels. So, how can you avoid it? Number one, you have to drink enough water because you need liquid in order for you not to be dehydrated. Most especially during this time sa napakainit. So, you have to intake more liquids. Do warm-up exercises before you do an activity. Before dancing, lagi niyong tatandaan na even Zumba man yan, you have to start with warm-up first. Lahat naman activity, it should start in warm-up. Next, do not overwork your muscles. When, sabi ko nga, if your body says stop, then stop. Listen to your own body. Kapag ka alam mong na-overwork mo na yung muscles mo, you have to stop. Not just in dancing, but also in other physical activities. Pag alam mo naman na hindi mo na kaya, huwag mo nang ipilit. Eat foods that are rich in magnesium and potassium. Mamaya bibigyan ko kayo ng list of foods that are rich both in magnesium and potassium. So, ayan yung mga dapat mong gawin or you can do in order for you to prevent muscle cramps. Again, kapag during na yung muscle cramps, hayaan mo lang siya. Huwag mo siyang lalong, alam mo yun, may mga tao kasi na kapag nakaka-experience ng muscle cramps, most of the time, ang ginagawa nila, sinusuntok-suntok, you don't do that. Stretch. You can do stretching. You can simply stretch yung kung sa may leg part mo yan, stretch mo lang. Tapos ipatulak mo. Diba sa mga athletes yung ginagawa, pinapatulak nila yung feet nila towards the body. Yeah, that can do. Pwede din yung gawin. So, these are examples of foods that are rich in magnesium. So, we have spinach, chard, pumpkin seeds, yogurt, almond, black beans, avocado, figs, dark chocolate, and banana. For potassium-rich foods, potassium is really good for your body. It can also be an aid in weight loss. Sweet potato, salmon, watermelon, coconut water, butternut squash, spinach, beets, and avocado as well. Maraming food actually na pwedeng maging under pa ng magnesium and potassium. But these are the top 10 or common foods under or that produces magnesium and potassium that can be used in order for your body to avoid muscle cramps. So, ayan, in case of a muscle cramps, what should you do? Stop your activity, relax, Stretch the affected muscle and massage to help it relax. Huwag niyong suntok-suntokin, you can massage gently. Once the muscle relaxes, pwedeng mawala yung cramp, pero pwede pa rin may part na masakit pa din. Kaya kailangan mo pa rin siyang ipahinga. Remember that for cramped muscle, wag na wag po kayong gagamit ng ice. Kabaligiran po ito ng sprain. So, you can wrap warm compress to help relieve the pain. And of course, keep yourself hydrated. Sabi ko nga, di ba, intake more liquid. And you can move the muscle kapag comfortable ka ng igalaw ito.